Chris Salvador, back here. I want to talk about global warming, and I want noise. That's what I want. I want noise. Well, I always have noise. There's always noise. Life is around me, man. There's life all around, you know. They want to make noises. They want to be, they don't want the messages to get out. Do they? No. So I want to talk about global warming. Global warming. What are my thoughts on global warming? My thoughts on global warming are this. I think global warming is a hoax. I was going to say bullshit, but, you know, hoax sounds cooler. It's a hoax. A hoax. The Incredible Hoax. Okay. I think it's a bunch of BS. It's nice. I saw it in Giving You Truth. I saw Leonardo DiCaprio's movie thing. I see the articles. I've looked all over YouTube. I've researched it. Basically, what is the thing? Is that it's the oil and the fossil fuels are being burned up and getting stored and trapped, and that's making the world hot. And that what's going to happen is all these weird weathers is going to start occurring. This place is going to get flooded. That place is going to have hurricanes. This place, and then ultimately, the grand master plan of global warming is that it's going to cause us to go into another ice age. Another ice age, because in the ocean, there's this thing, and it spins, and it has power, and it's going to stop that. It's going to stop the oceans. It's going to stop it, and then that's going to create an ice age. And it was all our fault, because we didn't turn off our computers. We didn't turn them off. If we just would have converted to using other forms of energy, the weather, we could have controlled it, and it wouldn't have caused the next ice age, and now everybody's fucked, and we're all dead, and the carbon dioxide is rising, and we're all dead. I would like go to a little passage in the Bible called Genesis 9:11, which is Genesis 9:11. And I would like to say, I'm not in Genesis 9:11, I'm looking at 11, hold on. There it is, Genesis 9:11. I was looking at Genesis 11. It doesn't matter! Genesis 9:11. It says, "Yes, I do establish my covenant with you. No more will all flesh be cut off by waters of a deluge, and no more will there occur a deluge to bring the earth to ruin." So, basically, God is saying, what did he say? No more will there occur a deluge. Deluge is like the great flood, something, some catastrophic event, like an asteroid coming to kill us, or the sun going to expand and explode and kill all of us, or a star is going to create a comet, and that comet's going to come, and it's the fifth element, and it's going to, all this, the world is going to die, and we're all going to explode, or global warming is going to come and stop the ocean, and we're all going to have an ice age and die. This says, no more will there occur a deluge to bring the earth to ruin. This is God saying to us. And now, what else does God say? And God added, "This is the sign of the covenant that I am giving between me and you and every living soul that is with you for the generations to time indefinite." Indefinite. "My rainbow." Rainbow. "Oh, my rainbow I do give in the cloud, and it must serve as a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. And it shall occur that when I bring a cloud over the earth, then the rainbow will certainly appear in the cloud. And I shall certainly remember my covenant, which is between me and you and every living soul among all flesh. And no more will the waters become a deluge to bring all flesh to ruin." Now, I'm sure many of you are saying, "Yeah, but what about Hurricane Katrina? Hurricane Katrina, did that cause entire nations to be destroyed, or just one isolated place?" don't know about you, but the weather is supposed to weatherize. That's a word I'm making. It's supposed to. You're so, yes, hurricanes do happen. Yes, thunderstorms brew. Yes, these things, they happen, but they don't kill everybody. The point, and that's the great thing about weather meteorologists, you can kind of predict and tell people, well, there looks like the cold front's coming in, and the weather, so, okay, so prepare, and be prepared, and, you know, okay, yes, it's a hurricane, it's category 5, it's very powerful, yes, but we could be more prepared than before. So now you're saying, what is the point of this video? The point is to say, I either have the choice between believing Al Gore, or I have the choice between believing God, who's telling me that never again is the world just gonna destroy it. The Bible has said, no more will there occur a deluge to bring the earth to ruin. So then global warming would technically be a falseness, right? I mean, would prove this false, right? I mean, because if it does bring the world to ruin, then that means this is wrong. And I don't think this is wrong. So then either Al Gore is wrong, or God is wrong. I'm going to go with Al Gore here, being the one that's wrong. Yeah, I'm going to go with that. I don't think that the fossil fuels are going to go in, and then the ocean's going to stop, and I'm going to be in an ice age, and I'm going to die. It's not the day after tomorrow. Yes! Things, you'll see some waters will rise here and there, but nothing that the entire planet is just gonna go, you're fucked, you're dead. Yeah, you'll see some hurricanes in some places that you, oh, I didn't think there would be a hurricane there. And oh, there's some thunderstorms over here. And oh, that was, there's some, is that some hail over there? Is that some this? Oh, yes, that will happen. You're right. Yes, I agree with Gore on that. Yes, yes, the weather is gonna get a little party here and there, but nothing that, but the oceans are gonna frickin' stop and kill us all, an ice age, I don't think so, take it up, Genesis 9-11, read it.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows, and what's on the other side? Rainbows are visions, but only illusions, and rainbows have nothing to hide. Ooh.